And welcome back for the best movies of 2016.
This year was the Female Appreciation Year of Cinema. Female Appreciation Year of the Cinema. Just because there were so many bad films doesn't mean there were no good films. Why am I hashtagging everything? Anyway, just to balance the list out, I had to make a list of at least 10 good films. I wanted to make a top 5, and honestly it is a top 5 but into two different categories, and the third category is a different category in itself. So it's actually top 15. So here we go. The first category is 5 good films that didn't perform that well in the box office, or I think deserves a bit more appreciation. Those films are Sarbjeet. Yes, Ae Dil Hai Mushkil had the worst of Aishwarya. Sarbjeet has the best of Aishwarya. Aishwarya has been on both the lists. This year was good for her. Honestly. Now, Neel Batte Sannata, it was a good movie. I think it deserves more than what appreciation it got. Even Dhanak the Rainbow, and also Aligarh, because honestly there are very few people who went for Aligarh. I know it's very serious, it's not the kind of movie that everybody wants to see, but hey, if you want Indian industry to change, go see these movies. And obviously Pink. Pink, because of the star cast, had a lot of recognition towards it, but I still feel it could have done way better. Way better. Because this topic is not just ongoing in life, in social media, in your personal thoughts. It's the truth. And this needs to be faced. And that is why it needs more recognition, is what I feel. And number one on this list is Angry Indian Goddesses. I know it's not exactly 2016's film, it's a 2015's film, and nobody would even flip on me. You know why? Because you did not even know. You did not even remember, and that's the issue. It is such a good independent film without a big banger, without a huge star cast, that I wanted to talk about it. It just came, sat there for 2 to 3 weeks and went. Nobody even talked about it then. And that is my issue, because it's a really good film. I think more people should have appreciated, more people should have seen it. It's a good film with good script, good acting, top-notch direction. Everything was top-notch, except for the audience. Because nobody talked about it in 2015 and nobody was talking about it in 2016, I think I wanted to put it up in my list so that people start talking about it. And I had to put that here because I don't want to make a 2015 list. If I do make that, I'll put that there again. So bear with me, but I don't think I'll make the list, honestly. So that is why I had to put it here. Angry Indian Goddesses was not your day-to-day female feminism kind of a film. It was something more than that. If you've seen it, you'll understand it and you'd like it for what it was. If you go for expectations of females showing cleavage, you won't get it. And good, you won't get it. You deserve that. You're an ass. The second category is the sequel. And this is a special category because the worst films had this category. I had to put it here as well because we had a lot of sequels. I'm not starting this with a countdown, I'm starting with a count up. Like, number one is Raman Raghav 2.0. Lovely acting, lovely direction. It's a really good sequel, worth watching. The same thing with Kahani 2. Kahani 2 is a brilliantly made sequel that had nothing to do with the story of the first one. See what I did there? Story, Kahani. Genius, I can't help it. Jai Gangaji doesn't have exactly the same charm as the first one did. Yeah, it was a good sequel considering the kind of sequels we had this year. And Priyanka obviously has good acting chops. 1920 London, again, yes, it does not have the same charm as the first one did. I don't know what first one had charm either or not. But anyway, Houseful 3. To go with no expectations, your expectations are not ruined. That's a good formula for a lot of films in India. I honestly don't know if this film list is actually going to be a good or a bad one. It's pretty hard to come. And the last one is Force 2. Because if you see the Force 1, you know that there is very less of a script, more of an action. And this one also, it does not work on script. So just good action. And a good action. I have to figure out this list is worst or not. I'm done. And then last subcategory that I want to nominate is commercial good films. These films are good. These films were so good that they commercially actually got their money back. And these films actually deserve to get that money too. You know, that's the difference. At number 5, I'm rating Rustam. Rustam was a good movie. Not just because it had Akshay Kumar and Riyan Dikrivis, but also because it was not just a true story, it's good. Honestly, the presentation, cinematography, the way the story was shot, to the way the story was presented, giving out the suspense only when it was needed, not overshadowing the story or the star. That is why it's on the list. Number 4 is Airlift. The star cast did not overshadow the story. The story did not overshadow the star cast. It was well shot. It had a good twist. The twist needed a good conclusion. It gave a good conclusion. It was good. It was good. And that's why it's on the list. Number 3 would be Dear Zindagi. Now, there is a reason that it is on number 3 and not on number 2 or 1. Is because Dear Zindagi had all the samagri. I don't know what to call samagri. I forgot English. I should go back and read 5th standard textbooks of English. Basically, it had all the ingredients of making a good film. The thing that took me off guard was, why is Alia Bhatt's entire life stranded around guys when she's interestingly seen that she has a thing to pursue? Why is not she pursuing that, and why is she just sewing around every other person in her family and her friends and her boyfriends? Why? Just no. But it was still a way better movie than any other movie that I've seen in that entire other list. Shah Rukh Khan's acting is good. Alia Bhatt's acting is good. He was a bit more focused on a career, and if that had created a bit more twist rather than guys in her life, I would have been more interested to see that. It would have gotten me to put Dear Zindagi on top 2 instead of top 3. Number 2 is Neerja. Dude, you got Sonam Kapoor to act. What else do you want? Except for the part that it's based on a true story, and except for the part that the true story was that tragic but yet inspirational, Neerja really gives you a hope. Also, when Sonam Kapoor acts well on it, it gives you better hope. And that is the reason it's on number 2. And number 1, if you've not guessed it yet, I think you should go ahead and see the movie and then guess it, because it's Dangal. Everybody's talking about it. Everybody. It's a brilliantly made film. It does not need a serene location. They had one twist which went throughout the film. It has more than one message to give, except for female empowerment, except for the journey of the kids. It has a story of how to make a medalist. It had one or two technical issues which I had, because I see those films that way, because I'm very critical, but the film was lovely. It's not a film, it's an entire journey which takes you from zero to a hero, which makes you feel proud about Geeta and Babita, Bhogat sisters. And it's lovely that we have them in our team, in our country. Not just that, it's really good to see that Bollywood has improved, that females are not just for objectifying the females, but they can have a story, a compelling story for their own character, which is really good. And this year has done that. This year has proven that if you have a female, it does not mean it will go a flop. And that's a good year. Now, because I could not include every good movie in this list, I have special mentions. That special mentions are for Kapoor and Sons. It was a good movie, but it was a bit too negative in the middle part of it. It could have been a bit lighter, but that's okay. I know what to say. It's a good movie. It was a good family movie, which you can't see with family. That I don't know how it works. MS Dhoni. MS Dhoni could have done way better. Way better, because I wanted to see more. And it can be taken in a good way, but it's bad way here, because I know what I want to see. That's not given to me. I'm a bit disappointed, and I'm not talking about internal politics. I'm talking about on-field strategies. If it's an untold story, the strategies are also untold, but you can tell them, right? No, you've not told me. So I'm disappointed. And that's why you're in the special mentions, not on top 5. Sorry. That's it, guys. That's all. Happy New Year once again, guys. I hope we get way better films that I can include in the next year's list, because I really want to include more films in the next year's list. In the good ones, not the bad ones. The bad ones is already overfully. What? Also, if you want more videos, you can subscribe, because I keep on making regular videos. I always keep making new kind of videos. This lists. If you want me to make more lists, let me know. I might do some comedy videos. I can do some dance videos. I'll be posting those from January onwards. That's this month onwards. Why is anybody knocking? Anyway, I gotta go. I gotta check out. Bye.